Welcome back to Final Fantasy 14. Here in front of Flamin, who apparently has something else for us to do. Flamin appears lost in her memories. Ah, Serenia, forgive me, I did not see you there. Ever since you spoke to me of your last moments with Minfilia, I find myself often thinking of the moments I shared with her. And it was during one such moment of remembrance that a missive arrived from an acquaintance in Ulda. Even now I can scarcely believe the letter's content, witness of an answer to my heart's lamentation. Such fortuitous timing is nothing short of a miracle, no less than your arrival here this day, I should think. I'm about to depart for the Sultanate to meet with my acquaintance, you see? But I cannot think of a better companion for this journey than you. Will you not indulge me with your company? I would not begrudge your absence, but if you're so inclined, it will mean more to me when you know. How could I refuse? You're too kind. We are to meet on the steps of Fal, in front of the Stamen Aesthetics. Pray go ahead and I will be along shortly. I hope I have not kept you waiting over long. Flamin? Thanks for coming on such short notice. Ah, both two. And I can't say we were expecting you at all, Serenia, though I suppose you do have a knack for assisting in matters of the dearly departed. So it is true? Did you find it? To start from the beginning, the consul was contracted to work on the waterways below Ulda. Naturally, this included the construction of a sill, the aqueducts. The place Minfilia and the others fled after the ill-fated banquet. Aye, and while we were clearing out the tunnels, a glint amidst the debris caught our attention. Ketzai, at first we wondered how it got there, of all places, but when we remembered the stone Minfilia gave you all those years ago, there's no mistake about it. This is the self-same stone. The very first stone she ever unearthed in those halcyon days when she was still called Asilia. She was beaming with pride when she presented it to me. It was a gift I would treasure for years to come. Until the day came when she needed it more than I. She seemed so lost that day in the waking sands. I knew the cat's eye would remind her of how far she had already come, and instill her with a little more courage to take the next step. To think she wore it all this time? When we searched the waterway shortly after the collapse, we didn't find a trace of her science, no belongings or anything. Curious that it would appear after all this time. With a stone in hand, Minfilia pressed onwards in her quest for true peace. Never once did she look back. And though she is gone, her legacy lives on. In you, Serenia, in the science, and in the child Ryne. Safe in the knowledge that others continue to walk her path, she has sent this stone back to me. This I choose to believe. She's earned her rest. I shall bury the stone, that she might have peace in the hereafter. Where are you thinking? Next to where her father rests. Indeed, there's no better place than with your loved ones. Well, you're doubtless keen to see to that, so we won't keep you any longer. We'll find a moment to go and pay respects ourselves afterwards. Till next time, take care. Thank you. Both of you. Warburton was interred here in Uldar at Erelik's burial chamber, but around the time of the Scion's founding. He was moved to the Church of Santa Dama Landama under the care of Father Iliad. Come, Serenia, let us seek out the father and request his permission to bury the stone. Ah, there you are. I was just telling Father Iliad about Minfilia and the cat's eye. Welcome, my child, welcome. Flamin has explained to me the purpose of your visit, and I see no reason to refuse you. Minfilia would wish to rest with her father. I have known her since she was but a child, full of hope and wonder, an aspiring young miner following in Flamin's footsteps. A dutiful student, to be sure. Nary a day passed that she did not set out into the wilderness with a pickaxe in hand. But fate would see her set aside the miner's tools, and instead don a mantle of far greater responsibility. She was as passionate then as she was in her childhood, a fire in her eyes that refused to be extinguished. It was that flame that compelled me to lend the Scions my support without a moment's hesitation. Yeah, unfortunately, a realm reborn didn't represent that very well. To now see so many brave and noble souls continue her work, it only reaffirms that I was right to place my faith in her. Forgive my meandering musings. You have not come here to hear me wax nostalgic. Pray see to burying the cat's eye. The 12th blessing be upon you. Thank you, Father Iliad. Come, Serenia. Robertson's grave is just south of the church. Here it is, Serenia. It was 20 years ago that Warburton came to Uldar, risking life and limb to warn us of a threat encroaching on Eorzea. 20 years ago, that my ambition robbed him of his life, a daughter of a whole family. You would have been proud of her. She was a warm, compassionate, and vibrant woman, always ready to answer the clarion call of duty without a moment's hesitation. Just like her father. In the end, that selflessness would save not one, but two worlds. Now her duty has ended, and though you are worlds apart, I pray that this stone, this precious gem from Marsilia, a part of her, remains at your side. Just as she remains forever in my heart. Marsilia. Never did I imagine such greatness could be born from a beginning so humble. I am proud to have been there for that first little triumph. Not only did you find a gemstone, you found your own path. That path took you far away to a place fraught with danger. You have achieved all that you ever desired, and you have returned. Rest now, Marsilia, my dearest daughter. Won't you say a few words too? Leave the rest to us. There's much I have left unsaid to Acilia, but I feel as though a weight has been lifted. With a lighter heart, I shall return to Mordona and resume doing my little part for the science, for her legacy. Wherever you may be headed, please take care, and when you meet them, do pass my regards to Fancred and Ryne and all the others. Thank you, Serenia, for everything. Okay. It was beautiful, but actually very short for an episode. Well, I guess then it's until next time when we play more Final Fantasy XIV. I'm Ace, and don't get lost.